I don't know if someone panic still.
That is his view, and I keep telling him he's one man and not a million.
You, let's dive it up. Hi guys!
We don't talk like that. So anyway, what we'll be doing today is we're going to be talking about marriage and your views on marriage and what a
Look
husband
at this dude.
Is supposed to do.
Wait till you see the.
And all of that.
No.
It's about to get hot in here, so. So let's get it. So what
so basically I'm just there.
Yeah, so what do you want to question about marriage? As we were talking about earlier, what a wife's supposed to do, what a husband's supposed to do, personality, characteristics. Go ahead.
Alright, so guys, everything that we say is strictly opinionated. So no one nobody in the comment section come and say, oh, you can't say that. I'm not nobody in the front. Yes, girl. I don't want it, bro. I don't want it. Just leave y'all's opinions in the comments of what you think. Alright? I'm sorry if I leave you on this channel. You know? Because I don't want nobody roast me. No. I feel it afar. Me just personally feel like, you see, when you decide to get married, right? The person, just as well when you're single, right? And you got in a serious relationship, certain things are drop. And then, based on discussions with your partner in the relationship before marriage, you hear some things with them that will want you to do or allow you to do. Or, well, not allow, but certain things will not compromise and agree to say you're not alright with it. With marriage now, me just feel like there are certain things. It's like you have, it's like you have bill, you know?
Fuck the builder, can we fix it? Fuck the builder, yes we can!
Scoop no. It's like you say, alright, we are shed them things, yeah? And I pick up new things to make each other stronger. That's how me think about it, you know? Cause me I say, oh, if you're in a relationship, and you know, say your partner love do this. When you get married now, and in a public, you do it to an extent. That's how me look at it. Kitty now, she have a totally different opinion.
Alright, so here we go. So, say for instance, you like art, right? And you like painting, and you have a lot of canvases, paintbrushes, different colors of paints, and you have like a collection of them, right? That is before engagement, marriage, everything, right? That is something you love doing. So you love doing something, your partner loves doing something as well. And then it's a case where they're gonna be like, oh, we married now, so they gotta go.
No.
Or some of them gotta go. They don't have to go. They don't.
Me agree with that.
So it's not a case where you're going to change entirely what you love doing or stop doing what you love just because it makes the other person uncomfortable.
And as me say, it's not that what she said, my two cents to that is me not feel like you're supposed to change or stop. As me say, I feel like there's levels to it. Alright. Let's say a partner love drive. Male or female, right? And you know, say yo, once you go up on sir, if she have a long trip, should I bring a particular friend, male or female, right? Alright, so let's say you're a man and your woman drive truck, right? And she go, for those in Jamaica, she's going to Mobile. For those in America, she's going cross state. But you have a one friend where before you get in a relationship, you should make you know the level. Right? She say, at the end of the day, whenever me I go a long distance, this person would follow me or that person would follow me. You get the full 100 now. So you can't say, oh, you never know. Because she tell you. So it's your choice if you want to work with it. So nobody go into the girl days and talk about, oh, me never know this, me never know that. She don't want to hear that, brother. So now, she said, she'll go cross state. And then after that time, you know, you realize, yo, alright, based on everything, all our characteristics, all our features, yes, alright, this is the person who I'm married. But, yeah, say, yo, know that you decide, say, yo, you gotta take a step there. And you put the question to her, pop the question, and she say, yeah. This is my congratulations, woo, engaged. Now she gotta go cross country again. She turned to you and say, yo, the person you have a couple with me. Personally speaking, I think, say, yo, no things, this is the part where you start, say, yo, it's not a case of, yo, all the time the person is supposed to come with you. You can look and say, yo, this is the case where, and all the time the person must come with you. You can look and say, yo, B, you know, say, or B, babe, honey, sugar plum. Yeah. You say, me, why you not invite me to come with you?
Because you're busy, you have a life, I have a life, I have friends, you have friends.
Have you ever asked though?
So, you don't know if the person asks. Yo, and all right. you turn it down and say, oh, you have something.
She asks once, you say she busy. The person say I'm busy. She asks again, I'm busy. Is it that you're supposed to stop asking?
Yes.
I mean, I agree with that.
We're women. We get tired of asking the same questions repeatedly. We get emotionally stressed. And like, we finish with things emotionally before we are physically done with it. So if it's a case where, oh, I ask my friend, hey, you're gonna come with me because such and such, my fiance said no, or my husband said no. So the company that I've always had is gonna, like, you know, accompany me while you're able to call me, you're able to FaceTime me if you want, but you don't. That is also another factor, communicating, because if it's a case where I tell you this person goes country or goes cross state with me all the time, and what would make it different now because we're married, there is no rule to say drop people when you are married.
It's not drop,
it's
but it's
different.
Limit.
I know
it's
there's limits. A limit and different levels, but you have friends and I'm allowed to have friends, male or female, and you cannot enter marriage without trust. If you do not trust the person, do not even think about getting married. Don't do it.
Cue the music.
Them gyal ya wicked, them wicked, them wicked. Them gyal ya wicked, them wicked, them wicked. I don't know how them so wicked. Why them so wicked? But I know say them gyal ya wicked.
Don't do it, because if it's a case where you don't trust the person, then you're gonna say, okay, they say they're going cross state, or they say they're going to country, and they're probably in a hotel somewhere doing the most. But then you can't actually think and say that, because then so as a man think it, so is he. That's what I was taught by my mom. So if I'm going to think that, or if the man's gonna think that I'm doing something, then in that case, then me gonna say, why are you thinking I'm doing something? Why you keep thinking I'm doing something?
Oh,
and it's
only reverse.
Fear. It's only fear that you don't assume. And you ask questions just to be clear, just to have an open communicating and all of that. But you don't drop people when you're married. You're the same person. You have levels and you have certain things that you don't pass a limit to.
Right. So it's just the case. Right? The man that used to, you never have a partner with across it. So if something happened, you can't expect him to react a certain way because he's not used to it. That's what me thinks too. Because if you ask for two time and the man say I'm busy, right?
Mm-hmm.
You might never know him because of the two time, he might look within himself and I say, yo, you know, so the second time this now, my partner asked me for come and because
of
work.
Men don't care. When they said, oh, she asked me the one time and she asked me the two. Men don't care, okay?
And this is our next thing.
They don't care.
In our next video, may I invite all of the team, them, the CZ team, them, the man, them. Them don't know, so sometimes I go through things, you know. You know, them don't know that, you know. And we have to hold it like a G because society. But anyway, that's a phonics video. So yes, man, them just leave me in the comment them. We're gonna have a whole video about that. Man attack and I express themselves. Because I personally don't feel like there's a platform for man in today's society. If a man come out and say, yo, me in tune with my feminine side.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
I know how to say Ray. I know how a female is feeling. And if a man say, yo, I can't relate to how she feels because I have. Oh, yeah, but him. We're not homophobic here in this channel. One joke aside, we're not homophobic because we're not homophobic, alright guys? Because me personally think say, yo, everybody live them life, them free to do them one, alright? Everybody them one big people, they make them choice. And the way the leaders of I'm gonna try to be serious. Alright, back to that. Back to what I want people. Alright, so teens and dreams, that's what I say. At the end of the day, a man, so man, like the real man them out of the road, you know the whole of the man them on the CZ team, you know someone a real man.
If you, oh, know, you know that they're real man.
Look at them subscribe. Come on, it's a rocket science. But you know, so you have some man, no look at them, say, yo, you know, so the second time this morning, wife say, yo, come with me, I'm a kind of power. I got work, I got move on some things. We say, you know, so the third time she asks, we say, alright. Matter of fact, me leave her a wait for the third time. I just try, you know, talk to her, see what her schedule is like for, you know, for the future. So I can say, alright then, ready. I got come with you, just surprise her.
My nigga.
That's me, I say, guys. Alright, so. It's a case where the man that look on it and say, yo, I'm going to move on some things for you, you know? For you. So the third time she asks, you're ready.
But men don't. They don't.
You don't know that. But guys, that's just our reason, you know?
But hold on. One last thing. You can't say what a husband's supposed to be. You can't say what a wife is supposed to be.
But
you met the person as they are. You are not God. You cannot judge the person.
But I'm asking. And I'm asking a question. Like, doesn't a wife or a husband, right across the board, share similar characteristics? Like every husband, you're supposed to can say, all right, this is the listing. Him tick this off, but him not tick this off, but him still show. I'm still sure character, I'm still sure traits of what I would look for in a husband to say, okay, if he asks me a question, I will accept it. That's what I think, though. You subscribe? You subscribe? Look there, sir. The subscribe button. You don't know what to do? Hit it! Hit it! Thank you. Bye!
I've seen a wife do something where it's okay with her husband because that's her. And I've seen where a man does something, I'm like, oh, mind try that? Trouble. But the thing is, you don't have a label on what a man should and should not do. It's based on your understanding with the person.
There isn't a golden rule, but...
But you're talking about a list. You can't list that for every married person in the world because you will not get the same answers.
Right, but what may I say is, right across the board, with if you get 100 females and I say, yo, where you look for a woman? Positive 5 answers out of the 10.
You're going to ask females what they see in a woman.
Yo, you know what I'm saying?
They don't. We're just talking about.
If you get 100 females and say, list 10 things you look for in a husband. Mm-hmm. But positive, 5 out of 10, right across the board, all of them are 5 things. That's why I mean, I say, yo, there's. And it all comes back down to you and your partner sitting down talking about things where you want. Me not gonna lie and talk. I'm not the greatest communicator. But because more I'm relationship, I tell myself that I'm gonna work for it. You know? I tell myself that. But setting aside that apart from that, what me I say is a man I gonna look for a female and say, alright, I'm gonna see this. This is what I'm gonna look for in a wife. And then a man, me would have said, if a man see a woman do something, he would have said, yo, B, you know, say, I don't like that. It's not giving wife.
And that's where he goes wrong, because
that's what
you can't say, are you going to judge a
person? But just the thing, say, certain things you're not expect of your wife.
Before the person was married, that is the person, so you're saying the person should not be a wife? Because you don't have a list of what to do and what not to do. It's based on you agreeing with the person, saying, okay, getting 10 stars is fine for you, driving here with whomever it's fine for you, going out with this person it's fine for you. Because you trust the person, you have trust issues, that's on you. And that's what we're getting at. And that's what men have an issue with, because me, I don't care. And if it's a case where you're going to do something, you should know what you're getting yourself into.
Yo.
Because, be quiet. Because, and if me walk up and down and not trusting the person I'm with, what is the sense? What are we doing? If you can't trust the person, what you do? Man, understand what you're doing. Trust have to come in first. And if you don't have that, you have nothing. Trust and communication. You don't have that, none at all. And me not fight that pan that with nobody. Because me trust you, you tell me, say, oh, yeah, go yasso with Shakira, and yeah, go yasso with Melanie. Okay. They are not me. They don't have what I have. We have an understanding. We love each other. And me know what me want. You're supposed to know what you want. So if you gone with the person and me the snow and fret. Oh, I wonder what they might do. I don't care.
My question is,
mm-hmm.
We have a partner, see? Woman. CVG, the females. If you all have a partner, right? And your male friend invite you out. Are you telling me that your male friend knows they're in a committed relationship, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And he might invite you out on a date. Mm-hmm. So what reason? If he invite you out on a date and say, oh, your man can't forward, then oh, everybody just catching up. Why is it that you need for go out with your male friend, just the two on to dinner? That doesn't make sense to me, brother. And that's why I say some man don't know them place, brother. Time and
okay, true.
Lincoln, big up. Big up yourself, Lincoln. Because you know where you're talking about. Honestly.
Yeah, that's true. Because
there's no way. I'm going to just, as I say, there are certain levels in a relationship. You see, if you have a female friend, as a man, you know, it's easy for you. If you have a female friend, right? You're not well close before the relationship, and then you know things start progress with your partner, and then when you get serious, and then when you say, yeah, come into the relationship. See, the interaction I've got to stop with a close friend. I said, I'm cut them off completely.
Exactly.
But you have to limit on the interaction now, because what? You move forward with your life. If the person you're committed to, evidently, you're not going to start build a family. Because me not see why someone they get in a relationship just to say, oh, me there with somebody. Evidently, they must see a future and not work towards a future. So, Money think you go do certain things to jeopardize your future with your partner. And that's how me look on this thing.
That is his view, and I keep telling him he's one man and not a million. Because he can only speak for himself. You have persons married and they're out there every day with somebody else. And you're saying you're married, so the man is not thinking that my wife now care that disease comes to me because we're married. Who else is she supposed to be doing it with? But she's not doing it. Well, she is doing it, but you don't know she's doing it because you trust that person and you say to yourself that she's a good person and she's this and she's that, when you don't actually know the person, if it's a case where they can't open up to you and have a conversation with you, it goes nowhere. But it goes to show that we are talking about trust and communication, and if you don't have that, let me tell you, down the hill. And your chicken little or something? Or door, it just keeps swinging?
And I'm not having my while again.
Oh my god.
But guys, this is my side. This is just weird talk. And you know, let y'all give y'all opinion on what we think about relationships and commitment and everything. But we want to know what all of you guys think, you know. Just make it in the comment section. Let
one question. One last question. Just a question. And I will know if you answer the question, because if you don't watch the video to the end and you don't answer the question in the comments or text me personally, then I will know you didn't watch it.
Let everything in the comments, my side. Every single thing. If you don't like it, if you like it, everything.
Right. I want to know, is it okay for your partner to buy another female something for a birthday or anniversary or something? And would you, as a woman, think to yourself that it's okay to buy a man, not your man, a different man, something for their birthday? I just wanted to just answer that question. So one for women, one for men.
Hey guys, as you know, Manea said, this is just us reasoning and letting y'all know, giving y'all a little insight.
Or views. You can state your view in the comments.
And more to tell you as well, like if you want to see more of this reasoning, or if you just want to see Kitty, I get blasted.
That works.
Just my good one. Yeah, you know, we're here for you guys. But, as always on this channel, at the end of the day,
a night.